Have you ever wondered if someone could be secretly reading your messages, seeing your passwords, or tracking every website you visit, all without you knowing? It sounds like something out of a spy movie, but in today's digital age, it's a very real possibility. Welcome back to Tech Sky's Ethical Hacking series, where we dive deep into the world of cybersecurity to help you understand both the threats and defenses in our interconnected world. Today we're going to explore a powerful technique known as a man-in-the-middle, MITM attack, using a tool called Bettercap. But before we begin, I need to stress something crucial. The techniques we're about to discuss are for educational purposes only. Using these methods without explicit permission is not only unethical but also illegal. Our goal here is to understand these attacks so we can better defend against them, not to cause harm. With that said, let's dive in. First, let's talk about what a man-in-the-middle attack actually is. Imagine you're passing a note to your friend in class. Now, picture someone intercepting that note, reading it, maybe even changing it, before passing it on to your friend. That's essentially what a MITM attack does, but with digital communications. An attacker positions themselves between you and the website or service you're trying to reach, potentially able to see or even alter your data as it passes by. Now, let's get into the nitty-gritty of how we can perform this attack using Bettercap. We'll be using Kali Linux, a distribution designed for penetration testing and ethical hacking. If you're following along, make sure you're in a controlled environment where you have permission to perform these actions. To start, we need to make sure we have Bettercap installed on our system. Open up your terminal in Kali Linux. The terminal might look intimidating if you're new to it, but think of it as a direct line of communication between you and your computer. We're going to type in some commands, and the computer will execute them for us. First, let's update our system's package lists. Type in sudo apt-update and press enter. You might be asked for your password, this is normal. The sudo part of the command gives us administrative privileges, which we need for installing software. Apt is the package manager in Debian-based systems like Kali, and update tells it to refresh its list of available packages. Once that's done, we can install Bettercap. Type sudo apt install Bettercap and press enter. The system will ask you if you want to continue, type Y for yes. This command tells the system to download and install the Bettercap tool. Great. Now we have Bettercap installed. But before we run it, we need to know which network interface we're using. Think of a network interface as your computer's gateway to the network, like a door that data passes through. Type ifconfig in the terminal. This will show you a list of your network interfaces. Look for WLAN 0 if you're on Wi-Fi, or Ethernet 0 if you're using an Ethernet cable. For our demonstration, we'll assume we're using WLAN 0. Now we're ready to start Bettercap. Type sudo bettercap iface WLAN 0 and press enter. The iface WLAN 0 part tells Bettercap which network interface to use. You'll see Bettercap's command line interface pop up. It might look a bit bare bones, but it's incredibly powerful. Our first step in the attack is to identify other devices on the network. Bettercap has a module for this called net.probe. To activate it, simply type net.probe on and press enter. This is like casting a wide net into the network sea, seeing what devices we can find. To see what our net has caught, type net.show. This will display a table of all the devices connected to the network, including their IP addresses, MAC addresses, and names. For our demonstration, we'll target the last device in the list, which we'll assume is our test Windows machine. Now that we've identified our target, it's time to set up our attack. We'll use a technique called ARP spoofing. Address Resolution Protocol, or ARP, is how devices on a network figure out which physical device corresponds to which IP address. By spoofing ARP messages, we can trick devices into sending their traffic through us. First, we need to enable full duplex mode for our ARP spoofing. Type set arp.spoof.fullduplex true. This allows us to intercept traffic in both directions, from the target to the router and vice versa. Next, we set our target. Type set arp.spoof.targets followed by the IP address of your target machine. This tells Bettercap which device we want to focus on. Now, let's start the ARP spoofing. Type arp.spoof on. At this point, we've positioned ourselves between the target and the router. Any traffic between them will now pass through us. Finally, we'll turn on packet sniffing. Type net.sniff on. This tells Bettercap to start capturing and analyzing the network traffic passing through us. And just like that, we're in the middle of the connection. able to see the network traffic. It's a powerful position, and in the wrong hands, it could be incredibly dangerous. Let's see this in action. On our target Windows machine, we'll open a web browser and search for VulnWeb. This is a deliberately vulnerable website used for testing web application security tools. Click on the first Acunetics web result. For demonstration purposes, we'll use the login form on this site. Remember, never enter real credentials on insecure sites like this. Let's enter a username TechSky and password subscribe, then click login. Now, back on our Kali machine, let's examine the captured data. You'll see a lot of information scrolling by in the Bettercap interface. If you look carefully, you'll spot our entered username and password in plain text. This is why it's crucial to always use HTTPS, especially when handling sensitive information. Now that we've seen how a MITM attack works, let's talk about how to protect ourselves from these types of attacks. There are several key strategies we can employ. Always use HTTPS. This encrypts your traffic, making it much harder for attackers to read even if they do intercept it. Look for the padlock icon in your browser's address bar. It's a simple but effective first line of defense. Be cautious on public Wi-Fi. Public networks are prime targets for MITM attacks. Avoid accessing sensitive information when on public Wi-Fi, or use a VPN. Speaking of which, using a virtual private network is another great strategy. A VPN encrypts all your internet traffic, providing an extra layer of security. Keeping your software updated is crucial. This includes your operating system, browser, and any security software you use. Updates often include important security patches that can protect against the latest threats. Using strong, unique passwords won't prevent MITM attacks directly, but it can limit the damage if your credentials are intercepted. Coupled with two-factor authentication, you can add an extra layer of security even if your password is compromised. Be wary of certificate warnings. If your browser warns you about an invalid security certificate, don't ignore it. It could be a sign of a MITM attack. Also, consider using a secure DNS service, which can help protect against some types of MITM attacks. For network administrators, there are additional steps you can take. Implementing DHCP snooping can help prevent ARP spoofing attacks on your network. Using static ARP entries for critical systems makes it harder for attackers to spoof ARP messages. Employing network segmentation limits the potential scope of an attack, and using intrusion detection systems can alert you to suspicious network activity that might indicate a MITM attack. Remember, cybersecurity is an ongoing process. Attackers are constantly developing new techniques, so it's crucial to stay informed and regularly update your security practices. In conclusion, man-in-the-middle attacks are a powerful technique that can be devastatingly effective in the wrong hands. As ethical hackers and cybersecurity professionals, understanding these attacks helps us develop better defenses and educate users about potential risks. Always remember to use your knowledge responsibly. The goal of ethical hacking isn't to cause harm, but to make the digital world a safer place for everyone. Stay curious, stay ethical, and keep learning. Until next time, this is TechSky, signing off.